Impugns is a temporary art installation that we've installed here at the Toronto Botanical Garden. It's a new and really exciting collaboration between ourselves, the Gary Smith, who is the artist and the creator. And so Gary's background, he is born in the Delaware area, which is renowned for gardens like Chanticleer, Winterthur, and Longwood. So he was raised in the context of botanical gardens and that whole public garden setting. And he's moved around from place to place throughout the United States working in botanical gardens and largely doing children's gardens and installations with native plants. So he landed here in Toronto following his partner's work. And so we started talking, and we were gifted a lovely donation by the Toronto chapter of Landscape Ontario. And so what we wanted to do with this gift money as a seed was to begin getting our members and the public excited about what could potentially happen on this space, and that is Stooks and Tunes. You're probably wondering about the title, Stooks and Punes. Stooks is an old word that we don't use anymore because we're not really in an agricultural setting, but Stooks is actually what farmers would use to put the grasses in piles, tall piles, in the field. So that was a stook, and that's reflected in these grass bundles. And a pune, you'll never have heard of before because it's a made-up word that just the artist Gary and his brother made up to describe his cowlicks on the back of his head. And apparently even his parents didn't know that they'd come up with that term. So it's now gaining international fame. Pumes. Made out of all natural materials, and many of the materials have actually come out of our own gardens, including the grasses. There were about 300 volunteer hours put into it, approximately 50 hands working on it at any given time, from the gardeners who cut the material to taking it out, bringing it back, and we had to dry. Do you remember the spring we had? This spring, it was rainy, like it didn't stop raining for 6 weeks. So all of those grasses had to be brought inside into our floral hall and laid out on the floor. It looked like a medieval feasting hall. The entire, and so we had all the fans set up and the temperature crank. Then we had to bring them out again, tied them, got them settled. We had Gary working with a really good crew of dedicated volunteers to create the punes. The core is actually an ivory silk lilac, which is a horticultural variety of lilac that we're growing in a brand new garden of ours called the Woodland Walk. The Woodland Walk is going to be filled with native plants and native trees, so having an ivory silk lilac stand there was no longer appropriate. So we took those down, and that's the center of the punes. And in fact, if you look carefully, there's one that is the ivory silk lilac doesn't realize it's in a base of 4 feet of concrete, and it started to sprout. One of the neat things about Gary's work, when we first researched him as a possible option, as a style, was we were grouping him with the likes of Henry Moore and also Andy Goldsworthy, who do really wonderful organic pieces of art and oftentimes with natural and found materials. So this was really amazing for us. He's a pretty amazing fellow in the way that he works. He really stays with the material. He has no real set idea of what's going to happen. He has some general sense of it, but he works with the material to see what it wants to become. And so when it's a finished product, he works with the public to see what they want to do with it. And it's fascinating. He had some interesting questions asked as he was creating it, which was just on site. People asked whether or not it was art. Is it just art, or is it something useful? It's a very different piece of art than we have in our gardens. So I think what we hope really is that it brings out a playful sense in everyone and every visitor. So it could be children, but it also could be adults. There's something really interesting about standing in the middle of these circles of strange shapes. And there's certainly visitors are invited to touch them and see what they're about. So I think could be anything from wandering, dancing, hide and seek, anything.